What's up, team players? It's your homie C-Rod back at it again with another set 8 hype. And today we are going to be looking at the Buris deck. And I have made a very powerful Buris deck. And honestly, I think all the Series A cards are pretty insanely strong. And Buris, Furious Strike, is no joke. One of the strongest leaders that's going to be coming out with the new set. You can build this guy with so many different variations, and he still kicks butt because this leader is ideally just a very powerful leader because of his activate main ability, which is choose one red or yellow card in your hand, place it in the drop area, draw two cards. That is explosion crazy good. Draw two cards for dropping either a red or a yellow is insane. And Awaken, he also restands two of your energies back to active mode, which is by far one of the best Awakening abilities in my opinion. And Awaken, the Awaken side, the Furious Strike Buris, he has an activate main that once per turn for one red and one yellow, you get to choose one of your opponent's battle cards and just KO it. Just like in the anime, the God of Destruction is just gonna blow things up. That's the leader. And what makes this guy even crazier is his activate battle ability that you get to choose one red slash yellow multicolored card in your drop area and combo with it for free once per turn during the battle. That is insane, allowing you to be able to bring out arrival cards with much ease just like that. And that is Buris, and now let's go into building the deck. So the way I went about building this deck is I'm gonna be going into the Ultra Instinct path, and Successor of Hope is gonna start that little engine going. So we're gonna be making Buris go Ultra Instinct, which I think in the anime, it kind of sounds like he could do it, but he's never really busted it out. So we're going to make it bust out in the card game. So we got Successor of Hope. I'm going to add this extra card because it's a zero cost. You just play it and then you get to search your deck, which is ideally awesome way to like look at your deck, see what's in your life, and shuffle your deck as well. And then you get to get a 5 cost or less swap card to your hand just like that, and it fuels your drop area. So we're gonna be adding 3 of these Successor of Hopes, very powerful. So now we're gonna, you know, get some help from the angel himself, Whis, Godly Fundamentals. And this card is exactly and you can only get it from the expansion set, the Magnificent Collection. And Whis, Godly Fundamentals, it's so good with the Buris deck because what you want to do is drop this guy, draw two cards with your Buris leader's ability, and he has an activate main that if your leader is Buris, which it is, you can send this Buris from the drop to the warp, minus 5k to one of your opponent's battle cards, and pick up a life to your hand. That is awesome for self-awakening. It's awesome for removing the little 5k battle cards your opponent has, and on top of that, you know, self-awakening. You could have all 4 and then just be like, I want to awaken now and pick up all 4. So we're going to be adding 4 of these because this guy is actually really, really good. So after that, we're going to be going into our extra cards, 1 cost extra cards. And it's going to be after Image Technique. Since we're going to be fueling our drop by dropping cards with our leader Buris ability, we're going to be having 5 to activate the Sparking 5 ability to use this card by taking a life or, you know, just counter. And this is a counter that does not negate the attack. It boosts up your leader by 40,000 and or a battle card by 40,000 and minuses 10k to one of your opponent's battle cards. So this card is very useful to survive one detrimental attack, save you from, you know, crazy attacks that would otherwise kill you. So now let's go to the one drops, and we're gonna be adding some pressure because this is an aggro deck. Red is aggressive, so we're gonna be adding some yellow aggressive cards, and I'm gonna add Fearless Assault Krillin. Sometimes you have those matchups where your opponent isn't gonna attack you, like Shenron and things like decks like those. So you wanna aggro your opponent down and awaken very fast. So we're gonna be adding Fearless Assault Krillin. He's a one drop. When he attacks, you pick up a life, 10k, and he's a crit. So he's a 15k crit going to your opponent and allowing you to self-awaken. We're only gonna be adding 3 of these because he is useful, but he is not ideally useful. It depends on your matchup. Ideally, when you're building a deck, guys, you want to build a deck that's, you know, it does fairly good against all matchups. And then another card I'm going to be adding is I'm going to add only one adopted father, Son Gohan. He is going to start the swap. I'm going to be adding some of the swap engine in here because, you know, I do run Successor of Hope. It's going to be able to be searched out. And on top of that, it's a one drop and you get to swap for a two cost Goku's lineage card. And he's also a blocker, worst case scenario. So we're going to be adding only one of those. And then let's move on to the two cost, which is going to be Whis the Spectator, one of the best cards for dual color cards, especially when you're talking about the red and yellow cards. This card is gonna be an active dual color energy if you already have another dual color energy in the energy zone. So this guy's just here for energy, and he also has a pretty cool ability that when you play this card, you get to negate one of your opponent's skills for the duration of the turn. Can be useful, but ideally it's just energy for that dual color energy action, right? So after that, now we're gonna get some more support of another god, and it's gonna have to be a green god because our leader is considered a god. So because our leader is considered a god, I could actually add the goddess herself, the only female god in the whole anime, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I cannot seem to find her. Is she a two cost? She is a two cost. Here it is. Elegant Assistant Hades. And super combo, four lives or less. When you combo with this card, if your leader is a red god or a Universe 2 member, you get to pretty much drop one card from your hand, draw two cards, get a 10k boost power. This card can save you a lot, and it also fuels your drop for one ultimate finishing play. And ideally, you need cards in your drop to use your Beerus's dual color ability anyway. So this is a very good addition to this deck. So now let's go to some yellow cards in here. And I'm going to add this Great Ape Son Goku Saiyan's Instinct because, you know, since we're going to be dropping cards to her drop area, this card works off of the drop area. Worst case scenario, you have a really bad hand. You can use this card from your drop. Use two of your energies. Doesn't matter the color. You draw two cards and you send this card to the warp. Very useful card. We're only going to be adding two of these. It's also good for combo power if you need a combo. So another two cost that we are going to be adding in here, guys, it happens to be Goku, Dependable Dynasty, because this guy is a 15k pressure. He could be brought out with the Gohan, the Grandpa Gohan swap, one energy swap onto this guy, attack, and you have a 15k attacking pressure, keeping the consistency of, you know, aggro with the red and the yellow. So we're gonna be adding just three of these guys because he is a very good card, and he could also swap for two energies for a three cost. That's Goku's lineage, which is gonna be the next card that I'm gonna be adding. Is gonna be the target for that card, and the target for that card is gonna be Son Goku Path to Greatness. This card is super strong. Barrier swap 8, so you could swap into an 8 cost Goku's lineage card. You do need to have 7 cards in the drop, but our leader drops cards and draws cards consistently, so you're going to be fueling the drop no matter what. Once he's on play, he is very hard to get removed from the field because he has barrier, and then you want to do the swap 8 for 4 yellow energies and an auto. Then when you play this card, you can also choose one of your opponent's battle cards, switch it to rest mode, and draw a card. Very, very, very key. This is the huge play, and this is how we're going to make Beerus go Ultra Instinct. Goku's going to show Beerus how to go Ultra Instinct. So now we're going to be getting some more god support, right? And I'm going to add Champa the Trickster because, you know, Champa is a god. He's Beerus's, you know, twin brother from another mother. And he is pretty darn good. A counterplay if you have a dual color energy, which we will. We have the Whis. We have quite a bit of dual color cards in here. So pretty much when your opponent plays a card, you can counterplay. Play this card, switch that card to rest mode, and draw a card. And it ignores barrier. So this card could really save your butt. And moving on, now we are getting to the bigger cost. We're getting to the four cost, and I'm gonna start off with some yellow cards, and I'm gonna add Topo, one of the best counters when you're running red for one red energy. The other one doesn't matter. When your opponent attacks during their turn, you get to counterattack, negate the attack, drop one red card. I mean, any card, actually. It doesn't even have to be red. Drop one card from your hand, place it in the drop area, fueling your drop area, right? And then negate the attack. And then your opponent cannot play, cannot attack you anymore with battle cards or any more attacks in general, even the leader. Because if they do, they're going to be dropping two cards from their hand. And that's going to be a very, very devastating attack that they're going to have to do. So Topo stops a bunch of people on their tracks. So we're going to be adding two of these. And then Vegeta, I'm going to add this Vegeta because he is a Universe 7 member. And choose one of your Universe 7 members and get 6K power for only one energy. And he comes out onto the field. Very, very useful card right here. I love this card. It's a red card too, so it could be used for combo power. I'm going to be adding three of these because it keeps the pressure going. And now, for the mother of all mother cards, it's going to be the Beerus dual color card himself. This guy is so darn strong. So when you play this card, you get to choose one of the abilities. You want to bring him out with a rival. Since our leader awakened allows you to choose one dual color card that's red yellow from your drop area and just combo with it during the battle, which it's giving you a free 10k boost combo, you're able to, you know, use one red, one yellow, bring this guy out with a rival. Upon play, he has two options for you. Either one, pop a battle card that's 30k power or less, and or choose one of your opponent's leader card or battle cards in rest mode, ignoring barrier, and that card cannot switch to active mode. Meaning, if your opponent's trying to do one big final triple attack, you know, play, it's going to stop them in their track. Beerus is very, very good, and we're running four of these because you need it. And then a little bit of spice that I threw in here happens to be, I'm going to add this Super Saiyan 4 Goku just because I like the card a lot. Might not be the best card in here, but I added it because it could be potentially very good. So this card is a triple strike offering card. So yes, offering meaning when he comes out onto the field, your opponent chooses between either losing a life to the drop area or letting you draw two cards. And the way this guy's going to be coming out is you got to choose one of your red battle cards that's 25k power or more, place it in the drop area, right? So who do you want to place? You want to place the Beerus, no holds barred, to the drop area. Hopefully you brought it out with a rival. You awaken. When you awaken, you place him to the drop area, and then this guy comes out onto the field, activates his offering, and now you got a triple strike going to your opponent, and it's whenever you awaken. So this is very, very, very powerful. So we're only going to be adding two of these just in case, worst case scenario, dual color energy or combo power from the drop area. So since we are running Path to Greatness, guys, we have yet to have talked about the victory. Whoops, I kind of spoiled the ending here. But we're going to be adding Hat of Mastery, Son Goku. This is what, you know, the Son Goku Path to Greatness is going to swap into. Once you have seven cards in the drop and you activate your Sparking, you swap onto this guy. He's a Deflect. He's a Triple Strike. He's a Dual Attack, which is insane. And when he comes out onto the field with the swap, you get to choose up to three of your opponent's battle cards or energy, switch them to rest mode, and then you got a triple strike, you know, a dual attack, and you lock your opponent out. This guy is the ultimate finisher of this deck. And last but not least, I kind of already spoiled it, guys, I am going to be adding Victory Strike. Drop one Universe 7 member from your hand in the drop area and finish off your opponent with a final ultimate Victory Strike. Automatically win when he deals one life. And that is the Beerus deck that I have made up and I think is very powerful. Let me know what you guys think. Try it out, modify it, pimp it out, make it the best it can be. This is my version, but I know somebody out there is gonna make it more broken. So like we always say, y'all stay super.